Hi, I'm Bill Frisell, and this is First Look.
Hi, I'm Don Woz, president of Blue Note Records. Welcome to First Look. Our guest today is my old friend Bill Frisell, who, in addition to being a very groovy human being, is probably the most innovative and formidable guitarist to come along in the last half century, although I know he's far too modest to cop to it. He's played with an incredible array of genre-busting artists, from Charles Lloyd and John Zorn to Ginger Baker to Marianne Faithfull to Elvis Costello to the LA Philharmonic. Bill's new album, which is his second for the Blue Note label, is titled Valentine and features his awesome trio with Thomas Morgan on bass and Rudy Royston on drums. Thank you for joining us today, man.
No, thank you. Thank you for having me. And I just want to say I'm happy to see you. It's good to have a little chance to talk, you know.
Absolutely, man. I've missed you. Where are you locked up, man?
I'm in Brooklyn right now, where I've been for the past. I guess my last gig was March 7th, and I got home, and then it was pretty much, that was it. I've been in this house ever since.
Yeah, I remember seeing your show. I guess we were in Sydney, Australia about a year
ago.
And I got to hear the trio perform and was really just blown away by the subtlety and elegance and the intricacy of the conversation. I'm wondering, what do you think it is about a trio format that offers this combination? You get tremendous freedom, but there's also a reliance and an interdependence on each other.
For me, it's really about the people themselves. I mean, I know there's this strength in the architecture. More than that, it's the trust and the personalities. It's the love that we have for each other. And for me, that's so important with whoever I'm playing with. Music is the world where anything is possible. You want to feel like you can take a risk. It's like when you're dreaming and you come to the edge of the Grand Canyon, and I want to just fly out there and see what happens. And that's what it's like playing with these guys. It's incredible.
The evidence is the album, which is, it's really an extraordinary record. I just love it, man. I play it nonstop. I've been riding a bicycle around, in fact, during quarantine, and I'm just blasting it. It's great. It just makes you feel good, and it's, as a musician, it's inspirational. The song choices on the album are wild. How do you choose songs for this trio?
I still want to have that feeling of uncertainty, you know, so I didn't want to work things out. We just did whatever we did at the Vanguard, and then when we went to the studio, there's some stuff that we never played before ever that's on the record, so I wanted to keep it like just a little off kilter, you know. When I'm playing a melody, I'm not thinking, well, this is a country folk alternative melody. I'm not thinking that, you know. It's just a melody. And so there's no reason why that stuff can't all coexist in one place.
Yeah, I agree. I always say it's like the you go to the library and they have the Dewey Decimal System, but no author says, I think I'm going to write a 600 book next year.
Yeah.
You're just right. When I saw your show in Sydney, you closed with We Shall Overcome. And I remember sitting there in Australia reflecting on some of the craziness that's going on back in our country. And it really reminded me of the positivity and the optimism and the hope that I remember from the 1960s. I got really choked up when you played it. Let's talk a little bit about the appeal of that particular anthem.
There's some songs that are just always relevant. You know, like you said, you saw us played in Sydney. What's happening now wasn't happening then, but there was something else happening that made it absolutely relevant. And I get strength from those songs, you know. I'm quoted as saying, I'm going to play that song until it's not necessary anymore or something. And I'm thinking, well, wait, I shouldn't have said that, because not to be dark, but we need to keep playing it. You know, we have to just keep reminding ourselves and be careful, you know.
Let's listen to a little bit of We Shall Overcome. That's We Shall Overcome from the Bill Frisell Trio's new album, Valentine. Now, keep your eyes open. That was previously recorded on your Nashville album, right? But it gets a decidedly different treatment here.
I think that was amongst this pile of stuff that I sort of threw at those guys at the last minute. So the arrangements, nothing's really figured out. That was another thing that when I first met Charles Lloyd, that he said to me, we didn't really have a rehearsal, right? And it's the first gig. And I went to his hotel room and he hugs me and he says, I'm looking forward to singing with you tonight. And that was like, oh man, that was all I needed to know. And that's what it's like. I mean, I don't really sing, you know, the guitar is how I sing. And, you know, it's really like just folks getting together and singing.
Yeah. Let's listen to that. Keep your eyes open. Let's keep your eyes open from the new album by Bill Frisell and his trio called Valentine. And let's talk about the title track, Valentine. I hear a certain nod to Thelonious Monk in there, correct?
It's probably more than a nod. It's plagiarism. Maybe. In high school, I had just discovered Wes Montgomery. It'll just open these floodgates, you know, from the music that I'd been playing. By that time, I was really into blues and surf music, to the Beatles, to the Rolling Stones, which taught me that, oh, wait, where is this music coming from? And then one thing leads to another. And then I heard Wes Montgomery. This is the summer of 1968. I didn't have enough money to buy all the records. I'd always get the best of this or the best of that and the best of it. You know, I got the best of John Coltrane, I got the best of Sonny Rollins, I got the best of Blue Note, Three Decades of Jazz. That was, that was one of the first albums I got. And on that album, you know, Lee Morgan, Bud Powell, Sonny Rollins, Miles Davis, Monk, he's just been with me. I don't think a day goes by when I don't think about Thelonious Monk. I think about that guy. And that music will not stop giving me something.
Let's play Valentine. I guess it's your Valentine to Thelonious Monk. All right, that's Bill Frisell from his new album, Valentine, the title track. Let's talk about what the world needs now. Burt Bacharach, Hal David's song seems even more timely now than when it was originally recorded by Jackie DeShannon in 1965. I love playing Burt Bacharach songs. They're always so satisfying.
Yeah, his music has come up in me so strong. And again, it, like I was describing with Monk's music, you look at it, stuff in there you can't believe. Burt Bacharach is one of those guys. Talk about detail and very unusual structures. Like that song, What the World Needs Now, you hear it on the radio and everybody sings along with it, but there's some harmonic and rhythmic oddities that are extraordinary, you know? So just on that, as a nerd musician, it's like, wow, this is far out, you know?
Let's hear it right now, What the World Needs Now. Thank you. That's what the world needs now, a track from the new Bill Frisell album, Valentine. Bill, it's such an honor and a pleasure to have you on the Blue Note roster. It's you put together such a great this album, and it's a record. I think it's really going to resonate from casual listeners to very serious musicians. It's a wonderful album, man. Thanks for being
Thank
here
you
with
so
us
much.
Today. Thanks for joining us on First Look. If you enjoyed First Look and would like to see more, please hit the subscribe button and also click the bell icon. That way, you'll be notified when we post our next video.